afternoon, guests, community members, staff, 2016, and Director Overall. My name is Izari Delir.
And my name is Brianna Borja Berumen.
And we welcome you all to our senior talk.
We are happy that you're able to make it today to an experience that my partner and I lived for the last 20 weeks. It began with an idea and made it into reality. And the dances you just saw are a legacy that will live on the East San Diego Charter School.
Prior to our senior talk experience, an email was sent out to the class of 2016 on July 8th and 15th by Director Overall. After receiving that email, Brianna and I did not know that dancing would bring us so many great opportunities.
It became surreal, because after learning the dance for our annual open house, we never would have thought that we would grow a passion for dance.
The first song that the class of 2016 was a song that slowly started to create a family. This special song, Be True to Your School, has been performed by the class of 2013, 2014, and 2015. Being true to our school was a great way to become a family. Along with this song, this year, we pay tribute to Motown.
Motown is the era of music that played a huge role in the racial integration problem that music faced in the 1950s. It was founded by Berry Gordy Jr. in 1959. Throughout the years, Motown became successful after producing most of the best-selling records during that time.
In order to pay tribute to Motown, seniors spent 70 days. Yes, 70 days. That's around 1,800 hours. Every second made our passion for dance grow stronger and stronger. Gee, Brianna, showing up to school along with a couple of friends, summer break is not something a typical teenager would do, right?
Right.
The class of 2016 created such a great bond after 2 hours of practicing. Gompers Preparatory Academy is definitely to be admired.
Yes. Opposite to what GPA is doing, many schools are up on their performing arts programs. And that is keeping the younger generation from finding their talents. GPA is refining this problem. How you may ask? Well, this year, a couple of groups gave the younger classmen the opportunity to learn different styles of dance. For example, Dulce Martiano Gutierrez focused on hip-hop. Adrian Reese and Michael Jaime focused on Jersey Boys to a group of middle school boys. And Tamika McQuill taught Glee. School's on.
However, Brianna and I were not as calm as we are now. But thanks to hearing, Who Cares If You Can't Dance? It's like no one's watching by a man that is so passionate expressing himself and about others expressing themselves as well was one of the main reasons why Brianna and I became so comfortable with our classmates. Thank you, Director.
His passion became our passion, and that is the reason why Open House was so successful. And because of this success, we would like to take some time to acknowledge those from the class of 2016. And if you have ever danced on the stage at any moment in time during the school year.
Please stand or remain standing if you came in during the summer during the Motown routines. That is almost half of the senior class. Let's give a round of applause. You may be seated. Because of this experience that we had been given, we can dance anywhere at any time without feeling
nervous,
comfortable,
shy,
or awkward.
This stage is where I did my first jazz walk. The stage where the class of 2016 became a family, and finally where we all discovered our love for dance. I didn't have the experience that I do now, but because of this service learning project, it not only made me realize what dancing can make out of people, but how important it is all to me.
Motown was the biggest show that I was a part of. You see, I was in elementary, I was in a talent show. But that performance compared to Motown was a hot mess. Motown was the first production where I felt comfortable and confident being on stage. Loved everything about it. The cheering crowd, the atmosphere, it made me feel great. My partner and I had a goal for our students and for ourselves. We told ourselves that by April 29, 2016, our students would know the Get Ready routine. And in the beginning of this presentation, we reached that goal.
mission of Motown Junior League is to give the younger classmen, the younger generation, the opportunity to gain confidence to dance. As we taught, our goal is for the younger classmen to be in an environment where dancing is a way to express themselves without being judged. Our goal was to create a family that had a love for dance, but the road to achieve this mission was not easy.
My partner and I had many challenges thrown at us. Communication is key, and that was something Brianna and I had a lack of. Consistently working was crucial towards our project. So when this occurred, Brianna and I learned how to talk things out and not to depend on our coach being the mediator.
It was hard being a full-time cheerleader and attending class at USD. Both extracurricular activities interfered with Motown Junior League, so I took a break from cheer and dropped out of the music class because I was losing so much energy due to having such a busy schedule. I was physically and mentally drained.
The most common challenge was probably being tired all the time. A lot happens during your year, right, seniors? Yeah. And sometimes having the energy to be engaged is hard. It was not easy doing practices and going home to focus on homework when you really just want to take a nap.
Who enjoyed the performance that began this presentation?
I know I did. They were amazing. In February, my partner and I started off teaching middle schoolers, but as time went by, it was now mid-March. Brianna and I decided to reach out to a group of juniors because we felt that it was time to start building a relationship with the new upcoming seniors.
As we became closer to our students, we started to realize how teachers feel about theirs. Teachers want their students to succeed and to become confident. My partner and I wanted the exact same thing for our students too. Our students' has been great, and we would like to share with you a short video which displays their progress starting February 10th to June 1st.
Enjoy!
When some loud bird tries to put me down and says his school is hate, I tell him right away, now what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of my school? It's number one in eight. I got for fun falling down. I'm proud to wear it now when I cruise around the other side of the town. I got my Dean Allen band. So be to your school. Up on the football game and I'll be ready to fight. We're gonna smash it now. My girl will be working at pom-poms now and she'll be yelling tonight. So true to your school.
Interesting how Motown Junior League evolved. After teaching middle schoolers for a month, my partner and I reached out to a group of junior girls because we felt that it was time to start building a relationship with the new upcoming seniors and because it was a great way to get to know the younger classmen. We created a Facebook chat. And in a blink of an eye, it became a group of 18. There are 52 females in the student class, and we got 18 of them to come in their spring break to learn the routines. They started earlier than any previous senior class had done, and we are so proud of them for that. Let's give a round of applause. Quick story. During the week of parent-teacher conferences, the younger classmates go home at 12:45, and the seniors no longer had that privilege. It was a Wednesday, which is the day that we usually meet with the junior girls for breakfast. Brianna and I were in our coach's classroom when all of a sudden we heard the songs that we were teaching the junior girls playing on the loudspeakers in the corridor. As we stepped outside, we noticed that the junior girls started practicing before practice actually started. It was at that moment when we were so proud to have reached out to this group of young ladies.
In just 2 weeks, the girls have learned two routines. The first routine is Mr. Postman, and the second routine is My Boyfriend's Bag. My partner and I are truly amazed by how comfortable and confident these ladies became with showing off their hard work. Because they're upcoming seniors, Izari and I thought a lot about how we wanted to become as confident as the dancers from the 2016. The first routine that they will be performing is Mr. Postman, sung and performed by the Marvelettes. Mr. Postman is a bud who is waiting for a letter from her husband who is away at war. Let's give the girls performing Mr. Postman a round of applause.
And now, Chicago, with hot new hits, let's hear it for the Marvelous Marvelettes.
How would you feel?
Gee, Brianna, I wouldn't know. My boyfriend's back. That is the second song junior girls will be performing today. My Boyfriend's Back was sung and performed by a group of three young ladies known as the Angels. Bob Feldman wrote this song after he witnessed an altercation between a high school and a tough-looking boy who wore a leather jacket. The girl yelled at her for telling lies about her at school and actually said a phrase that became their song, "My boyfriend's back and you're gonna be in trouble." Wow, it must have been a serious lie, but that was a long time ago.
Give a warm welcome to the junior girls performing My Boyfriend's Back.
Back and you're gonna be in trouble.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
See him coming, better out on the double.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
You've been spreading lies that I was untrue.
La, hey la, my boyfriend's
so
back.
So look out now, 'cause he's coming after you.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
He's gonna save my reputation.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
If I were you, I'd take permanent vacation.
Hey la, hey la, my friend's back.
Gonna be sorry you were ever born.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
'Cause he's kind of big and he's awful strong.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
marks the 16th week since practices first started. And my partner and I always seem to get really happy when we think about this experience. I became a better person through this experience by building a special connection with our students. We share laughs and we talk like each other for the longest. And being able to stay after school to teach to play apples to apples makes me happy.
With the hopes that Motown Junior League continues to be a part of Gompers Prep Academy, my partner and I would like the junior girls to continue this group their senior year. We would like the junior girls to teach the younger men the routines that the class of 2017 will learn for their opus.
Every step is important.
Yes, as this experience progressed, my partner and I wanted to ensure that each step was a fun one. In order to get feedback on how we're doing, we decided to survey a couple of our students. Here are some things.
My favorite part of Motown Junior League was dancing with my friends.
It's a great way of bringing people together. Motown helped me get my comfort zone.
I like being in front of people and being able to have fun.
My favorite part is sharing this passion with all of you. I find it pretty amazing how we all get together with positive vibes and enjoy what we do.
These statements by a couple of dancers you saw today. As weeks went on, we started to figure out who our students are and what they like. And to tell you all the truth,
every single student that came to practice throughout the weeks or during breaks bring joy to Gompers Preparatory Academy. Without them, partner and I wouldn't have the love and dedication to spend our time enjoying their presence. I learned many keys that will help me in the future. I learned how to be patient with myself and with my students. I learned to cherish the time that I got to spend with them.
We remember the first weeks of our summer break and how it was a time of growth for the both of us. It was truly unexplainable.
We wanted to be a safe place and a family, just like the people that came in summer did for us.
We wanted to create a no-dead zone.
And we created just that. Because of Motown Junior League,
I made new friends.
I was able to step out of my comfort zone.
I'm not shy of dancing anymore.
I got to improve dancing. I could be more enthusiastic. I got to bring a new bond. I could
bring a new bond. I got to meet new people.
I stopped being shy. I became a better person.
I made a better connection with my peers.
I got to express myself.
I was able to de-stress.
And
we are a family.
My name is Brianna Borja Berumen.
And my name is Izari Delira.
And this concludes our senior.